The Application Builder allows you to develop both internal and public web-based applications on top of your Baserow database or other data sources. This video focuses on user authentication. User authentication verifies the identity of a user before granting access to an application and its data. The Baserow Application Builder relies on a username and password combination for this purpose. The goal of user authentication is to ensure the security and integrity of the application. In this chapter, you will learn how to create a table of users, assign users to an application, set up a login page, process user information, and adjust the visibility of elements based on the user authentication. The objective is to build a portal that enables volunteers to see their registered events. Therefore, each volunteer needs an account on the portal. It is crucial to understand that this account only authenticates users for the portal application. It never provides direct access to any associated databases. The database already has a table that contains volunteer information, like the name and email. This table will serve as the repository for the user accounts in the application. The only thing missing is a password for each volunteer. This can be solved by adding a new field of the type password. Unlike other field types, the password field prohibits reading but only allows setting. This security measure ensures that the password is never stored as plain text and therefore cannot be read by anyone, even not the database administrator. Assign passwords to several users, remembering that password changes and resets are always possible. The next step is assigning the volunteers table as the repository for the users of the application. This can be done through the application settings. Select the Users tab and click the Add User Source button. Currently, the only available type of authentication is through a Baserow table. Select the integration, which is a database in the same workspace, and offer the user source a name. Click Create. The following step is selecting the appropriate database and table, which is in this case the volunteers table. Finally, select the fields that hold the email address, the username, and the password. Click the Save button to complete the configuration of the user source. Remember, adjustments to the user source can always be made later. Additionally, note the possibility of having multiple user sources within a single application. With the user source established, it is time to set up the login page. There's no need to create an entirely new form, as the login form is an integrated element within the application builder. Simply add this element to the page and choose the volunteer's user source. By default, the login form spans the entire screen, but this can be adjusted in the style panel by setting the width to medium or small. The Events tab contains the After Login event. All available actions are accessible for this event. In this scenario, once logged in, users will be redirected to the Events Overview page. To test this process in preview mode, enter a correct email and password, which should redirect the user to the Events Overview page. Any incorrect combination of a username and password will trigger an error message. The events are stored in the Schedules table, which includes a Volunteers field. This field is a link to table field to the Volunteers table, containing all volunteers registered for events. The Events Overview page has a data source listing all events where a volunteer has signed up for. This is achieved by verifying if the Volunteers field contains the ID of the logged-in user. To test the application, there's no need to repeatedly run it in preview mode using multiple login credentials. The application builder enables real-time simulation of logged-in users via a drop-down at the upper left corner of the page. This drop-down presents all volunteers from the user source, facilitating a quick simulation of a logged-in user. For instance, Amy is signed up for 6 events, and Anita has signed up for 5 events. Additionally, it is possible to display the logged-in user on the page and provide a logout option. This is demonstrated at the top of the page, where a text field shows a welcome message followed by the user's name or email. The button on the right side triggers 2 actions upon a click, navigating to the home page and logging out the active user. Run the application in preview mode and note that there is no logged-in user. This is because the application was directly opened on the Events Overview page. Given the absence of a logged-in user, all elements on the page appear empty. Enhancing the user experience requires displaying a message that prompts users to log in. This can be achieved through the Visibility tab. The table, header and container with login information should only be visible to logged in users, while an alternative header should be visible to users who are not logged in. The header image must remain visible at all times. Upon testing the application again, the Events Overview page now presents only a message and a login button. After logging in, it displays the relevant information for the logged in user. Refreshing the page will cause the login message to reappear, since preview mode doesn't retain user data between page refreshes. User authentication unlocks numerous opportunities for the Baserow Application Builder. It allows to identify external users and show only the data that is relevant for them. It is essential to remember that these external users never have direct access to the database. Their interaction is limited to the data provided by the application. Establishing user authentication starts by creating a table with at least a username, email, and password field. This table is then assigned as the user source for the application. Finally, the application must include a login screen. And once set up, the authenticated user can be referenced at from anywhere within the application.